And now we will learn how to record owner's withdrawals. This means paying personal expenses from business funds. There are four kinds of owner withdrawals transactions. The owner takes cash from the business bank account. The owner spends money from the business bank account for a non-business reason. The owner spends money from the company credit card for a non-business reason. And lastly, the owner takes home a non-cash asset. But for that last one, that's a special case, and we'll see how to do that in the following video. The first three are done like any other check or credit card charge. For ATM withdrawals and non-business payments, use the write a checks window. It's very simple. For credit card charges, use the credit card charge window. It's very simple. In both cases, the owner's withdrawals is the account that the money is paid or charged to. That means the withdrawals account should go at the bottom of the window for both write a checks and for company credit card charges. So here's the first example. April 20, Holden withdrew $200 from an ATM and spent the cash for non-business reasons. And they gave him an ATM slip with the transaction number like they're supposed to. Now that's very, very simple, and we're going to record it in the write a checks window. Before we write the check, let's take a look at the trial balance. We know that right now Holden's withdrawals, where is it? Holden's draws, or Holden's withdrawals, is $7,000. But if he withdraws $200, that means after this transaction, this will be $7,200, and the cash in the company bank account will go down to $9,800. From the main menu, we click Banking, Write a Check. We put the date, April 20, and we know whomever we paid is whomever we would put here. But now remember, we're taking it from the company bank account. Just click OK. And we're paying it to Holden's draws, Holden's withdrawals. Remember, the top account is where the money's coming from, and the bottom account is where the money's going to. And of course, in this case, it was $200 that he withdrew from an ATM. And of course, instead of a check number, you should really remove this. Instead of a check number, you put the ATM slip number, because 987654, because you need a transaction number that you and the bank can both trace it to. Now, when we click Save and Close, you can see Holden's draws has increased to $7,200 and the cash in bank has decreased to $9,800. Second example, just as easy. April 21, Holden wrote a check to his son's dentist for his son's tooth cleaning, $100. Check number 65. Well, that's obviously not for business, so we do it the exact same way. So, banking, write a check, okay, it's check number 65, so we put the field here, check number 65. Normally we would put the name of the dentist here, but you don't have to if it's withdrawals. Okay, new vendor, just dentist or whatever the guy's name is. Now it was $100, but the fact that it was not for business means that it's coming from the company bank account, but it's going to Holden's draws, also known as Holden's withdrawals. When we save and close, we can see Holden's draws increased by 300 and cash in bank, Holden's draws increased by 100 and cash in bank decreased by 100. Now let's try this last example. The last example is also the same thing, even though it's from a credit card. April 22, charged $300 from the company credit card for the family vacation. And of course, they give you a number on the slip that you can uniquely identify the transaction. So if we pay $300 for non-business reason from the company credit card, it's actually a Discover card, That means that after we record this transaction, Discover Card will show up here for the first time with a balance of $300, and Holden's draws should go up to $7,600. From the main menu, we click Banking, and then we record Enter Credit Card Charges. And this window is just like the Write a Checks window. The only difference is it's taking it from the company credit card rather than the bank account. But it's exactly the same idea. The number on the slip is the transaction number. Whomever they charge the money to would go in the payee field. We skip that. The money amount is $300. And the account, it's being paid from the company credit card, but it's going to Holden's Withdrawals. Why? Because it's a charge for non-business. After we click Save and Close, we can see Discover Card shows up for the first time as $300, and the total money that Holden took out from the company for non-business reasons altogether from the beginning was $7,600.